In this lesson, we're going to look in more detail at the condensation of those amino acids to form peptides, and we're also going to look at how we name those polypeptides from the abbreviations of the amino acids. So here we're looking at two of our simplest amino acids. We have glycine, which is abbreviated GLY, and that has the H as its side group. And we're looking at alanine, which has CH3 as its side group. And so we have these two separate amino acids, and what we're going to do is look at what happens when they form that dipeptide. Now, this is a condensation reaction. So remember, we're going to lose a water molecule in that condensation. So we're going to take out a water, which means we're going to lose our oxygen here and lose two of our hydrogens. And so what we're left with is a carbonyl carbon that's not bonded to an oxygen. We've lost that. And we'll form a new bond from that carbon over to that nitrogen. And that nitrogen's only going to have that one hydrogen left. And when we lose this water molecule, we also lose the charge because that's neutralized. So now we see that the new bond formed from the carbon of the carbonyl group to the nitrogen on the other amino acid, and we see that that new bond has formed. So this is the new bond that formed between those two amino acids. Notice that nothing else in the structure changed. We started with NH3 on the left. We have NH3. We have CH with another hydrogen attached. We have a carbonyl group. We see this is where the new bond formed. Then we have our N, which we still have one hydrogen left. Then we have CH with a CH3. Then we have a carbonyl. And then we have our O minus. So the only thing that changed was we lost our water molecule and we formed a new bond from the carbonyl carbon to that nitrogen. And that's going to happen every time we see two or more amino acids coming together. If we had 10 amino acids, we would see the same thing, except we would now see another bond forming to this carbon, to a nitrogen, and so on. The bond is always going to form between a carbon and a nitrogen, and we will always see the same backbone again and again. Nitrogen, carbon, carbon. Nitrogen, carbon, carbon. So even if we have 20 amino acids in a sequence, we'll still see that same backbone pattern. So now we want to look at these two molecules and see if you can determine if these are the same molecule or if they are isomers. Remember what the prefix iso means when you're looking at them. So these molecules are actually isomers of one another, so B is our correct answer. Because what we're looking at is we're going to start by tracing along the structure. We're going to find the N termini, and we see here our N termini, and then it connects to a CH with an H, but here we see a CH with a CH3. So while they have the same two side groups within that dipeptide, they're in a different order, and because of that way they're connected in the backbone, we see these have a different structure. And so these would be isomers of one another. These are not the same molecule. If we look at the name of these, what we see is we have glycine alanine. Notice we start naming at the N terminus. The first group is glycine, the second group is alanine. Here, we start again with our N terminus. The first group is alanine, the second group is glycine. So these have different names and they are in fact isomers of one another. Another one to look at here, if these are the same molecule isomers. Remember on the previous example, we started from the N termini on both molecules. So these are actually the same molecule, because what we want to look at is that we need to start at the N termini on both of these molecules. And I see an N termini on the molecule on the left, and I see a CH with a CH2OH group attached. On the N termini for the amino acid or the molecule on the right, I see CH, CH2OH. Then I see my carbonyl group on both. Then I see NH on both. Then I see CH with a CHOH and a CH3. So I see the same connection there. A C double bond O and an OH group. So these are the same molecule. They're just drawn in a different way. Whenever we're comparing peptides, Whether they have two amino acids or 200 amino acids, we always start with the N termini to compare them to see if they're the same molecules or isomers. Another thing to notice is that this is written as the neutral molecule. In the previous molecules we looked at, we saw that they were drawn as NH3+ and O-. Either form is correct as long as you're consistent. Either write them both neutral or write them with a plus charge on the N and a negative charge on the oxygen. When we look at the names of these, we see it's serine 3-anine, because the name always starts at the N termini, regardless of how the molecule is shown on paper. So here's a tripeptide, and what we see is that we'll see the same pattern in the backbone, NCC. So although there are three amino acids together, that pattern of the backbone doesn't change. What changes are the side groups, and here we see we have three amino acids because we have three side chains. We have this group, and this group. So those are the three amino acids, and we see we start have our N termini, we have our C terminus, and we still have that same backbone pattern. The new bonds that we formed are between the carbonyl and the nitrogen, so we formed a new bond there and a new bond there.